I am going to talk about the attitude of the student towards robots in educational environments. Nowadays, there are many projects that aim to promote computational thinking in a student to teach computing. Exploring different programming environments, developed tools, and generating material to these students. Several of these projects use robots for this goal. We are interested in exploring the relationship between age and previous experience using IT technology for the acceptance of robots as teachers. In particular, this work analyzes the performance of a group of students when the same classes were taught by a robot or by a human teacher. These students have participated in a technological campus at the University of Leon. We used two different tests to attain this goal. We have proposed a large scale to evaluate this attitude in different experiments. Also, we have studied the RAS scale to measure people's anxiety and in order to evaluate the student attitude towards robots, we designed an experiment where the same computational concepts are taught by a robot and by a human teacher. The human teacher was a programming teacher with more than 10 years of experience in programming courses at university level. And the robot teacher was an industrial robot that consists of 2 7 degree of freedom arms attached to a torso topped by a head made up by a display. The same script was used in both. First, teacher gave a brief lecture using the same outline and the same slides. Then teacher explained the exercise that the student should carry out. And last, the student would make the exercise and fill a questionnaire. Well, the lecture starts with both human teacher and master following the same script for explaining two basic programming concepts, repetition and condition. In this case, Baxter would additionally solve these two concepts with a demo. They call a ball of a ramp and put into a box. Well, after the explanation, a practical exercise was proposed. The problem had to be solved using a Scratch programming environment because they have been learning about it in the summer camp where they were participating. The exercise consisted of building a swimming pool in Minecraft world. Minecraft was chosen because it's a very popular game among the students. The total number of students that participated in the experiment was 210. 114 had robot teacher, and the 19th examen had a human teacher. The student age range was from 6 to 17. The experiment result had been analyzed as a whole and also by groups. Group division were made according to the Spanish educational law in three groups. The NAR questionnaire have been used to measure the psychological state reflecting opinions that people used to have about robots. Present three types of questions: negative attitude toward interaction with robots, toward social influence of robots, and negative attitude towards emotional interaction with robots. The RAS questionnaire measure emotion of anxiety from interaction with robots having function of communication in daily life. Also present three types of questions: communication with robots, negative attitude about robots' behavior, and about robot discourse. As summary of the frequency answer to NAS and RATS scale can be seen in the following tables. This table shows the distribution of the different answers for each item. In the paper you can see the distribution of the different answers for each item organized by groups defined by age. It is possible to see differences in attitude toward robots between the student answer depending on the age group. In the next table, show the results of the statistical analysis of the NARS items when comparing the human lecture group versus the robot lecture one. It also includes statistics about the number of students that interacted with the human teacher and with Buster robots, the average value of the item for each group, standard deviation, the result about the NAS questionnaire. We can see that most of the students feel comfortable interacting with robots. Also the result that students are not especially worried about the future role of the robots in our society or about the good involved. In the case of the emotional interaction with robots, the student feel comfortable being with robots that have emotion. The result about the RAS questionnaire about the communication with robots show that the students should not be worried about the behavior of robots during a conversation. About robot behavior and how robots move, the strong they are, or what they are going to do when you are interacting with them, seems to worry younger students. Finally, about robot discourse, it is possible to see that younger students are more worried about talking properly with robots than other ones. In conclusion, we have found some differences that we attribute to the ignorance about the real robot's work. When the student interact with a real robot, they are aware of the current limitation and their fears are alleviated. The final results show low evaluation to robot as teacher. What will happen in the future? Well, I don't know, but it's important the interaction between robots and students. Thanks for your attention.